U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen also calling world leaders to action at the COP26 summit. Yellen underscored the urgency needed to address global warming. She also announced the U.S. will join the U.K. and backing the new capital market mechanism of the Climate Investment Funds. CIF was established in 2008 to mobilize resources and investments in low- and middle-income countries. It has drawn some $10.5 billion in pledges and leveraged $61 billion in funding for projects that have benefited 72 countries to date.
Glasgow and COP26 is a pivotal moment at the start of this decisive decade of climate action. The climate crisis is already here. This is not a challenge for future generations, but one we must confront today. Rising to this challenge will require the wholesale transformation of our carbon-intensive economies.
Financial firms managing around $130 trillion, or 40% of the world's capital, have pledged to put limiting climate change at the center of their work. Dubbed the Glasgow Financial Alliance for Net Zero, the group of more than 160 financial firms was pulled together by UN Climate Envoy and former Bank of England Governor Mark Carney. He says the group needs to find creative ways to channel private money into investments that advance the push for net zero greenhouse emissions by 2050. According to Carney, an estimated $100 trillion of investment would be required over the next three decades.
We need blended finance facilities that don't mobilize fractions of private capital for the public dollar, but multiples and multiples in double digits for the public money. There are facilities that are being developed that can do this. We need to scale them dramatically. Quite frankly, facilities that do not scale up to $100 billion a year in additional flows aren't relevant to the scale of the problem.
The Asian Development Bank launches its plan for an energy transmission scheme in Indonesia and the Philippines, a first of its kind in Asia and the Pacific. The ADB's ambitious plan is to build public-private funding vehicles to buy coal-fired power plants and retire them within 15 years. This would allow countries time to switch to renewable energy. The Philippines is eyeing Mindanao to pilot the ETM project.
The government is in the process of rehabilitating the Agus Pulangi hydropower plant to improve its generating capacity. As we increase its generating capacity, the ETM project will help us acquire coal-fired power plants on the island to repurpose them. This will shift most of our energy requirements in Mindanao to hydropower. There will soon be numerous investment opportunities for renewable energy in the region.
The United Nations rolls out funding plans to strengthen weather forecasting in vulnerable countries. Details in this report.
The United Nations has announced that it's rolling out funding plans to improve weather forecasting in vulnerable countries to further protect them from climate change, including 75 small island nations and least developed countries. The announcement was made at the big climate conference happening in Glasgow, COP26. The countries targeted by the initiative have done little to cause the climate crisis, but face the biggest and costliest impacts as climate change triggers deadly heat waves, droughts, and floods. The World Meteorological Organization said weather-related disasters have increased fivefold over the last 50 years, and more than 91% of the associated deaths have occurred in developing countries. The initiative aims to plug gaps in weather monitoring and data collection so developing countries can better prepare for climate-related disasters. For example, in recent years, weather data for Africa has declined as readings from weather balloons equipped with observation equipment decreased by about half between 2015 to 2020.